Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind, the Black Pits. We're about to take up Krancor and company, the people who hang out in this cell over here and have random little things to say. I hate to kill them, but they actually killed us. But hopefully we're better prepared this time. I'm going to see if a bless spell will last into the battle from here. So I'll just center it here. I hope it hits all of us. It should. Because Bless just takes so long to cast and only lasts 6 rounds.
Indeed.
Ha! You have returned!
Yeah.
Are you ready to spill blood on the arena?
I wonder if it'll still be active.
You've beaten my hobgoblins, which means you're exceptionally strong.
We're blessed right now.
You've also bested my pet spellcaster.
So I noticed something. I know I turned this off. So I'm going to quick save. I don't know if it switches it on, but it's making characters switch to other modes. It's making, instead of them using their slings, they keep going to fists. I mean, that's what you really want. A magic user going up and punching somebody. So, let's try again.
Certainly.
Ha! You have returned! Are you ready to spill blood? You've beaten my hobgoblins, which means you're exceptionally strong. You've also bested my pet spellcaster, which means that you're stubborn. I can clearly not rely on one extreme or another. So instead, I shall crush you with a combination of combatants. Carry on!
So his... he's protected by minor spell turning, so using magic missiles on him would just be a waste. So, let's start out with magic missiles on this guy, Owen. And then you attack him, you attack him, you attack him. He's running right over to these guys. Okay, more magic missiles. You're attacking him, right?
I am indeed.
Actually, see if we can get Agnes or a Scorcher here. Oh, we got the magic user down. She's good. All right. I'll get the cleric.
Yes? It will be done.
Andor. Okay, the cleric's down. Alright, good. We are doing better so far. Maybe now take out this archer who keeps going after him. That's, I'm guessing, is an archer?
With ease. Not a problem.
Onward.
not a problem.
Oh, that's better. I think it was the AI that was really screwing us up.
With ease. I stand, it will be done.
Attack Krancor the Old.
To battle!
Because he's old. Attacking Rianne, are you sure? Go after, I guess, Carlos.
Your concern? Indeed.
Just try to reposition her for that Agonizar Scorcher. Did I hit him? Carlos, okay. And she's out of spells, right? Yeah, so go to range. He's got another one. Anyone attacking him? Oh, he's out? Oh, he's out. Who else is out? Oh, it's him. Alright, we've just got this one guy left. This is, Cyril? Or one girl left? Who is Cyril attacking? Rianne? Oh no, Carlos? That was Carlos. Well, I think we're gonna be okay. Everyone attacks Cyril.
It is done.
Which one's... That's Rianne.
Indeed.
Done it.
Inconceivable! Get out of here and take your reward with you.
I don't think that word means what you think it means.
Ridiculous! Outstanding! Impossible! Fantastic!
It's a lot of adjectives.
You've managed to crush everything I've thrown at you. Clearly, I have excellent taste in selecting gladiators.
We are the ones who are excellent.
You've survived for longer than I expected and gained quite a following in the process. But don't worry, you'll be dead soon enough.
Well, I won't worry then.
I've dug out some of my rarer beasts. Very soon now, they'll crack your skull open and feast on the gooey innards.
Sounds delightful. Hey, Baloth, we've served our purpose. Your guests have been entertained. Let us return home, and you can find new combatants.
Oh, don't be such a preposterously petulant persnicket. I'll tell you what. Because you've been so gracious about all this kidnapping and forced to fight to the death business, I'll give you a reward.
Okay, some more money.
Now go get ready for your next battle.
Oh, there were goodies.
You'll most likely be slain, so it's probably time to perform whatever funeral rituals your culture requires.
There were goodies in that battle. I forgot to pick them up. Some kind of magical staff? Damn it. What's going on here?
Impressive, mortal. Your feats in the arena have become a frequent topic of conversation. Perhaps you will set a new record for longest surviving combatant.
Is there nothing you can do to help us escape?
No. Baloth has tasked me with giving you this reward for your outstanding performance. Take it and prepare for your next battle.
All right, someone leveled up. 20,000 gold? Wow. Gallus, Meryl, and Andor. Okay, saves have increased, wow, by 2. Save versus breath by 3. Thaco improved, 12 more hit points. Gallus. Saves increased, pretty much the same. 15 more hit points. Same saves, 12 more hit points. And Rianne. She got a level 2, now she gets a level 3 spells. So we can, of course it's going to be cure moderate wounds. 10 more hit points. Unfortunately, it's always cure moderate. Medium wounds, whatever you want to call it. I'll take away one of these silences. Try a hold person. Draw upon holy might. The chant spell. All allies within the area of effect gain +1 bonus to attack rolls, minimum damage healing rolls, and saving throws. lasts for a turn, which is like 10 rounds, I believe. Furthermore, damage dice for all effects outside a weapon's base damage is reduced by 1. And something multiple chance will not accumulate. That sounds really good, actually. I mean, is that like an improved version of Bless? Which one is it? Chant. Plus 1 to attack. Damage and healing, saving throws. Attack and damage rolls by 1. Okay, I'm gonna take out one sleep. I mean, what am I doing? He'll keep the sleep and the charm person. So I got a lot of money. That's good. We need more healing potions. More oils of speed.
I am here. Indeed.
Way to go! You've been really terrific down in the pits. Do you need some more potions? My buddy the concoctor is ready to squirt out some more.
Alright, looks like we have achieved a milestone. These people are saying more things. Wait a second, what do you mean, squirt out some more?
Haven't you noticed? The concoctor doesn't mix ingredients in flasks and cauldrons and such the way a gnome alchemist would. He takes the ingredients into his own body, where they blend in exactly the right proportions before he excretes them to make the potions you need.
Wow. Sorry guys, I'm having problems. USB issues. Ew. So he ingests them and excretes them out. So I've been drinking the concoctor's...
excretions! Oh. Wow, now that I say it out loud, it does sound kind of icky.
More than kind of.
Now, can we put some new potions in you today?
Tempted to say no at this point, but we really do need them. Two oils of speed. I'd say 8 of these would probably be fine. Another potion of Hill Giant Strength. Oh, we have new potions. Okay. We got the Oil of Fiery Burning and Explosions. Stone form, which I've never really messed around with. Unfortunately, it affects dexterity. Clarity. Agility, insight, magic, shielding. Oh, it's a lot of money. Mirrored eyes. Well, we'll see if we can find out from the beholder what we're facing next. Oh, he's still got one. I keep forgetting that. She has... Give her 4. Oh, and he needs arrows. I got 2 left. I'd say 1, 2, 3 more potions. This is better used by him, because he has a bonus on it. Give her that. Three more healings. Thank you. Actually, both of them. So we wander around and talk to these people. They have more things to say now. We need to get arrows.
Certainly.
Watch yourself. With every battle, you anger Baeloth more and more. Soon, he will pit you against an unbeatable foe.
Perhaps if I beat enough of his monsters, he'll become angry enough to face me himself.
No. That will never happen. It mustn't. If any of us gets to fight that hateful drow, it must be me.
Well, we do have new spells, but we don't have the levels for them. Unless they've given us some more level 2 spells. I wonder how effective this can be. The spell has no effect on creatures with more than 20 hit points. It only affects one creature. Yeah, that's pretty limited. That's not really that great. Spell magic is level 3. Got up to 5 now. Alright. Thoridek?
Your prowess in battle has become well known. Perhaps it was my weapons that tipped the balance in your favor.
Perhaps. And perhaps you could fashion a blade that would cut Baeloth down.
To cut down Baeloth? Don't talk like that. He'll hear you.
I don't care.
Besides, under the effects of his gaze, you could never use it against him.
Geese or geese? Don't you want to be free of him?
Of course, you fool! What loyal Durga wouldn't? Unlike my cousin Gorge, I just have no illusions about its happening. He's too clever to fall for that. I've never seen anyone make him lose his cool. Now, are you here to buy some weapons or talk my ear off? What'll it be?
That'll be... Tuck your ear... Nah, show me some wares. Okay, I don't have anything we want.
You've lasted longer than anyone expected. I'd start taking bets if anyone nearby were man enough to speak to me.
Are you and Brendak having a spat?
A spat? Is that what he calls it? Then why doesn't he say so to my face?
No, Brendak didn't say anything like that.
Ever since that accursed drow captured us, Brendak hasn't said a word to me. He speaks to anyone else, just not his own wife.
Can't say I blame him. Curious.
Curiosity killed more than a cat, you know.
Probably, yeah.
Listen, do you want to buy some weapons or not?
Yes. Okay. No. I think this guy has ranged equipment.
You're still alive. How? Baloth surely would have destroyed you by now.
Baloth.
Perhaps he is merely toying with you.
Maybe I'm the one toying with him. Maybe you should think about that and tell me what you know of his weaknesses.
But you wouldn't torment me as he has, would you?
Of course not.
No, I don't dare cross him again. His savagery knows no bounds. Please, hurry and take what you need before he sees us talking.
Why would he care that you're talking to me?
It's not you. It's me. Baloth has a special place in his black heart for torturing me. He gladly takes any excuse to place me in the pain room.
The pain room? There's a pain room? Black heart for the black pits. Well, that sounds bad. I understand why you're frightened.
Please, just tell me what you need and go.
I'll be nice to him. Or rather, not nasty to him. We have special arrows now. Sweet! You know what? Before I buy these, acid, fire, or ice piercing, let's see if we can find out what we're up against. Of course, now we have bullets, too. Plus one. How are we doing with bullets? I don't think we use that many of them. Let's buy some bullets plus one.
Indeed.
It's 20. Too far away. Okay. And before I run back there, let's talk to these people.
Your con- indeed. Yes? Indeed.
I can see you staring daggers at Baloth. You look like you want to say something. Don't you have a mouth or a beak or something under all those tentacles? Alright. Let's take a peek. So the Wand of Fear only has one charge. It's lame. I'm really gonna have to choose carefully. I'll be back.
So, you have not yet been eviscerated?
No.
You may allay my disappointment by buying more of my fine clothing.
What's your problem with me, other than being an evil demon?
Your scent is even more offensive than usual for a mortal. And you show me no deference. Were I not Baloth's guest, I would tear out your innards with my bare claws. The singular virtue of your kind is the way you scream and writhe while being torn limb from limb.
How exactly did you come to know that?
You would be surprised at how easily one becomes carried away while appraising a mortal for alterations. Now then, shall I take your measurements for a new garment?
That's really saying something that you're only the second creepiest vendor at this booth.
I see you find Zithus's silence as disturbing as his appearance. He should never have defied the will of Baeloth. After subduing the Illithid, Baeloth drilled the Mind Flayer's telepathy right out of its brain.
Oh wow. I didn't even know you could do that. So he was basically like maiming him.
The ghastly wretch can speak the common tongue well enough, but it pains the monster to be reduced to what it considers such a crude form of communication.
I see now why you and Baeloth are friends. Oh. Ooh, that's nice. Cloak of Displacement. It's pretty good. These are cool. Oh, I want to find these in the main game. Immunity to fear and panic. That's got to be really helpful. Electrical resistance plus 100%. Cloak of Protection. Here we got new stuff. The Cloak of Displacement is a magical item that causes subtle shifts in the image of its wearer and has the power to actually shift an individual's image by as much as 6 inches in any direction from their actual location. Aside from being an effective defense in combat situations, it has also been the cause of serious eye strain amongst fellow party members. I think I've read that description, but this looks different. It's like so vibrant. Cloak of Bravery. Really? This cloak is an evil thing, albeit powerful, made from the poorly stitched together skin of innocent nymphs. Oh my god. This cloak grants the wearer immunity to fear and panic. God. That's horrible. I'd feel bad just buying that thing. Cloak of Reflection. Vorn Druid Slayer crafted this cloak and used it with great success in his campaign to eliminate the Druids from all the woods south of Baldur's Gate. His campaign ended abruptly when he encountered a flock of wyverns who were attracted by the cloak's sheen. They killed Vorn and used the cloak to cover their nests, serving to protect their young during electrical storms. Clever. Well, that's cool. But before I buy this stuff, let me see if we're gonna need it for anything. Let's talk to these people.
Ah, the ones who have stymied Baeloth. He says he wants a good fight, yeah, but he really wants good death. So longer you deny him yours, the more he will pit you against deadlier foes.
Didn't your people fight against him first?
Vidurga tried to fight him, but his spells were too powerful for us to resist. Funny, not everyone was at that battle. I still wonder what became of Thardek. Just before entering the battle, he returned only when it was over, and Baeloth had already placed me here to serve his gladiators.
Do you know how we could take the fight to Baeloth?
Perhaps you could force his hand by depleting his supply of minions. But he continually brings in more and more exotic creatures.
True. Well, thanks. Ooh, got Falarain's plate. One of my characters in the main game is wearing that. We need a lot more money for all this new stuff.
You've made quite a splash in the arena, and I'm not even talking about the blood.
What's wrong between you and Magda? Are you seeing someone else? Oh, that's Brendak. Okay. She's yelling across the room to him. For some reason, I thought these two were together. That's Thardak, not Brendak. That's why I got confused. Very similar names.
You've made quite a splash in
the arena. What's wrong between you and Magda?
Of course not. I love Magda. It's just, I don't want anything to happen to any of us. Belos torments us all, and he knows how much I love my wife.
Has he forbidden you from speaking to her?
I've already said too much. I'm supposed to sell you armor. Do you want any?
All right then, Mr. Attitude. Let's see. Studded leather armor plus one. This stuff is... We'll drain down all this money really quickly. All right. Let's go talk to... Well, I guess this... This is empty now. Kill these people. Is there someone in here now? There is. Thespia. Treacle, Lucille, Lucius, Red Tom, and Voadica.
So, you're the current favorite. May Tamora favor thee until we meet in the Black Pit.
I thought it was Timora. You can't beguile me with polite words, Red Wizard. I know you're kind.
Do you? We Red Wizards may appear similar to outsiders, but no two of us are alike. You are quick to judge based on appearance alone. Interesting.
Actually, I was basing more on, like, vocation.
They are obviously no match for us, my mistress.
We'll see about that. Hello.
Are you prepared to face your next match? When facing superior physical strength, be sure to protect the most vulnerable members of your party. And never forget that an attack can come from any direction.
Okay. Pretty much what I already attempt to do. An attack can come from any direction. Well, thanks. That doesn't give me any hints on, like, what I'm gonna be facing. Like, if he had said, okay, you're gonna face people who use lightning bolts a lot, then we would buy up stuff that protects against that. We've been running long enough. I'm gonna ruminate on what we should spend our, well, almost 20,000 on. This guy, I think we can sell this. Note from Krancor. I'll hold on to it. It's 60 gold. If it comes down to that, I might sell it, because Krancor is now dead. It's... the note comes... to Alluend? These people aren't Alluend, right? Let me just take a quick look, and then we'll sign off. Maybe it's someone else we're gonna meet up with. And then I could... have a dialogue or Easter egg or something. No, I'm not seeing an Alluend here. Alright, so next episode, guys, shopping. And then the next set of combatants. AI is still off. And make sure it stays off. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always seek adventure.